this lecture, I want to talk about the rebound effect, a phenomenon in which while we have increased efficiency in a process or a technology, there's still a net gain in the energy use. And we'll quickly define efficiency. It is the ratio of the useful work performed by a machine or process to the total energy expended. And the rebound effect is easily seen through examples. So many cars have increased fuel efficiency now, but knowing that, we tend to change our behaviors. So we design and build bigger and faster cars, there are more cars on the road, and we drive them more. So any of the gains that would have come from the efficiency are essentially wiped out by these behaviors. Printing and paper is another good example. Back in the 1980s, when offices were just starting to get computers, people said, oh, we're going to have paperless offices. We can look at everything on our screens. But what actually happened was that it was so efficient and cheap and easy to print things out that that's what people did. And now there is much more paper used in offices than in pre-computer days back in the 1970s and before. Green policies can have unintended effects, rebound effects. So in the Netherlands, people bought hybrid cars, thinking that they would do something good for the environment. But for convenience, they actually ended up driving them often in the gas mode. And so they ended up spending more energy on the car than they would have with a conventional car. And this was also reinforced by the fact that the Dutch government gave huge rebates. So that motivated people to buy the cars, and they were so cheap that people didn't pay as much attention as they should have to the efficiency of what they were actually doing. Technology begets technology. It's additive. So we have computers, we have music players, we have tablets, we have smartphones, we have game consoles, we have smartwatches, we have other wearables. And as we add these technologies, we don't get rid of the old ones, we keep them around. So even though each individual technology might be more efficient than it was in the past, we continue to add new technologies to our repertoire. This is consistent with our capitalist economic system, in which corporations have to grow at about 3% a year. And this is quite an aggressive target of growth. It's hard to keep that up. So companies have to always be trying to sell us more goods and services, or they will go out of business, or their shareholders will not be happy. So this kind of dynamic is built into our system. The rebound effect has a lot of impacts. It affects energy use, materials consumption, and electronic waste. As you probably know, we have a huge and growing problem with e-waste. There's a lot of toxic chemicals that go into the manufacture of information technology. We really don't have a good way of dealing with this, and this is something that we are trying to work on. It's important to do a socio-technical analysis of the rebound effect and not to just look at each individual technology in isolation. So what we want to do is measure the input and the output of the entire system, including people's actual behaviors with the technologies, and certainly not just look at the efficiency of an isolated technology by itself. So to do this kind of analysis, we start with the math. Efficiency is a ratio, so there's only so much it can tell us. To control resource use, we have to define absolute acceptable levels of whatever quantity we are interested in. So for example, we have to place a limit on CO2 emissions if we are actually going to end up in the end with a reduction in emissions. Lawrence Hilty is a professor of informatics and sustainability at a university in Germany, and he has studied the rebound effect extensively. He says, as developments up to now have clearly shown, there is a risk that more efficient technology may induce more material and energy throughput through the economic system than it saves. And he recommends that we accept more virtual, immaterialized goods and services to offset the rebound effect. I think this is a really interesting direction for future research. Here are a few articles. There's a lot on the internet. If you want to read more about the rebound effect, there's one by Hilty, and all of these are available and highly recommended. Thank you.